Mars, one of the most dreaded planets in the solar system. Companies like SpaceX are already dreaming of this red planet. But one thing that we haven't quite talked about that much, other than in movies, are poop potatoes. No, seriously, what would you eat on Mars? Mars makes its close approach to Earth once every 2 years, so there is no point in taking food from Earth to the mission over to the red planet. And since the trip to Mars takes around 7 months, for that, yes, they have to keep 7 months worth of food in the rocket. So again, the question arises, what will you eat during the mission? Food is probably going to be the hardest thing to make locally on Mars, and you can't just import it all if you want to have a self-sufficient settlement. Given this challenge, the scientists wanted to see what it might take to reach the radical goal of producing enough food on Mars to feed 1 million people. The researchers noted that raising farm animals for dairy and meat just wouldn't be practical on Mars in the near term because of challenges like shipping cows across space. At the same time, they noted that most people do not want to go completely vegetarian. The solution? Insect farms and lab-grown meat. Insect farms are well suited for Martian cuisine, as they provide a lot of calories per unit of land while using relatively minor amounts of water and feed. Crickets in particular are one of the most promising examples of edible insects, the cricket flour potential incorporated and hidden in many different recipes. When it comes to crops, the concept art of Martian settlements usually features greenhouses, but these may not prove very practical. Since Mars is so far from the sun, even on the equator where sunlight is the strongest, the amount of light that plants would receive would be similar to what they get in Alaska. Moreover, although greenhouses are made of clear window panes, these still typically absorb between 50 and 70% of light on Earth and may block even more on Mars. Since a stronger material is likely needed to support a heated, pressurized interior, given how the air on the red planet is much colder and thinner than on Earth. Instead, tunnels lit with high-strength LEDs are likely to grow plants on Mars, supplemented, of course, with sunlight collected and piped down through fiber optic cables, as suggested by researchers. Soilless farming involving hydroponic or aeroponic systems is possible, but these strategies would require more mass shipped to Mars in the form of trays, pumps, and reservoirs. In addition, soil-based farming may be more robust against plant disease, but inorganic Martian dirt would require significant research and treatment to convert it to a living soil that could support plant growth. Previous research suggested a number of crops may prove especially practical when it comes to feeding Martian colonists, such as wheat, corn, soybeans, peanuts, and sweet potatoes. Genetic modifications could also make plants much more useful in a variety of ways for Martians. For example, by consuming more carbon dioxide and boosting productivity. To see what it might take to feed a Martian city of 1 million people, the researchers modeled a population that grew from immigration as well as through a birth rate of about 10 per 1,000 people per Earth year, a rate typical of developed nations on Earth. All in all, they assumed about 6,900 crewed ships were needed to deliver about 1 million immigrants to Mars over the course of a century, with about 340,000 people born on Mars during that time. The scientists calculated the number of calories each person would need. They found that a Martian colony of 1 million people could achieve self-sufficiency in terms of food within 100 years, relying on about 9,000 miles or 15,500 kilometers worth of tunnels about 12 feet or 3.6 meters wide, which could be stacked vertically. However, these colonists would need massive amounts of food imported in the interim, carrying on nearly 54,000 cargo shipments. The scientists noted there are a variety of strategies that could be used to significantly reduce the amount of imported food, such as increasing the rate of farm construction on Mars. Future research on how to best feed Martians should focus on boosting crop productivity, working out the most efficient and palatable insect species, improving the flavor and texture of cultured meat, improving the efficiency of the LED lighting used to grow crops, and developing automated methods for rapidly building pressurized shielded areas to house farms and for emergencies. So what about poop potatoes? Well, that's possible, but not for the first colonists. Bugs are going to need to be the most appropriate form of food for the first few batches of people on Mars. Do note that there will be at least 5 to 6 missions for cargo and machinery before any humans are sent to Mars. Next, let us talk about how would SpaceX make rocket fuel on Mars? Well, actually, let's go ahead and save that for another episode here on Discover Zen.